Hello students, welcome back to Dr. Noor Firdaus Johar channel, wherein you are exploring the world of business management with Dr. Noor. So today we are here to discuss or continue our discussion on behavioral theory of leadership. Hope you remember in my last video I explained you about two behavioral theories on leadership. That was OEO University theory and what was one Michigan University theory on leadership was explained to you in my previous video. Today we are here to discuss, based on those two dimensions, we have come up with two behavioral theories of leadership, that is managerial grid and Likert management system. So total behavioral theories, four are there. So OEO University, we have discussed in the last class. Then Michigan, I have discussed in the previous video. And today we are here to discuss managerial grid and Likert management systems. Very important theories, the behavioral leadership theory. Our leadership theory based on the behavior of the leader. So today we'll be discussing these two in today's class. Please keep watching my channel. Yeah, before I start with this, let me ask you, have you subscribed to my channel? If not, please do it right now. I share my videos to others and like my videos and pass and please view all my previous videos to get the whole principles of management subject is there in one playlist of mine that is called as Principles of Management. I think some 40 videos are uploaded till now, teaching you the full subject of management and the basics of management. Everything is discussed here, which not only help business study students of PUC, then BBM, BCom students, MBA students, but also help people who wanted to write their UGC NET in management, or people who wanted to write UPSC exam and take management as a specialization. This is a subject which is going to help you in detail. So let us discuss that in detail. So I'll start with the first one now. So please, with that note, let me start with the first one, managerial grid. So what is managerial grid? Very important. Again, I'm telling you, please make a note of it. Managerial grid, correct? I'm teaching you as a behavioral theory of leadership. So this managerial grid also believes that leaders are made, not born. And leaders will, through virtue of their action and behavior, they are going to get success in their leadership job or failure in their leadership job. So their behavior determines whether they are the good leader or they are the bad leader, not the trait. And this theory of managerial grid is propounded by Robert R. Black and Jane. Yes, Montaigne. Please make a note of it. The managerial grid is given by Robert R. Black and Jane S. Morton. Commonly we call it as Black and Morton. Commonly we call it as Black and Morton theory of behavioral leadership theory, or it is also called as managerial grid by Jane and Morton. So what is this managerial grid? As the name says, grid is nothing but the graphic model. Grid is nothing but the graphic model. This theory is presented in a form of a grid, that is in the form of a matrix. A graphic model is being given, propounded by Black and Montaigne here. So managerial grid is a graphic model of alternative combination of managerial style or behavior on a two-dimensional space. These two styles are concern for people and concern for production. As you know, students, in my previous class, previous video, we discussed about Michigan University and Ohio University. They also talks about two dimension, that is concern for people, concern for production. Managerial grid given by Black and Mountain also talks about concern for people and concern for production. According to this theory, leaders are most effective when they achieve a high and balanced concern for people and for task. And according to this theory, they say that leaders should have high concern towards people and they also have high concern for production, then only they are successful. Nor they can ignore people, nor they can ignore production. Both are important. And they are shown on vertical and horizontal dimension of grid. And the grid have cells between 1 to 9. The scale of the grid is 1 to 9. Our degree, of the grid is 1 to 9. Let me show you the graphical form of managerial grid. Please have a look at the board. So managerial grid diagram, you can see my x-axis, I have put concern for production, y-axis, I have put concern for people. So concern for production, I have given 1 to 9, correct? Then concern for people also 1 to 9, the scale is 1 to 9 everywhere. So x concern for production, y concern for people. While drawing this grid, no, don't forget to write the x-axis what it is, y-axis what it is. Otherwise you will not get marks. Concern for production, concern for people. 1 to 9. 1 is low, 9 is high. 1 is low, 9 is high. Now, concern for production is 1. Concern for people is also 1. That is called as 1-1. Failure leader. Nor is good in people concern, nor is good in production concern. He is not going to do anything properly. Then you have the highest category is 9-9. Concern for people is also high. Concern for production is also high. Quite successful leader. Then both is average. People also average, he take care. Production also average, he take care. Overall is the average leader. 5-5. Then you have concern for people is 0. He is least bother about people. But production he takes care. Correct? Then we call it as 9-1. One more leader you have, concern for people is very high, but concern for production is very low. So that also kind of leader. So let me show you all these 5 types of leadership according to managerial grid diagram, which is given in the scale of 1 to 9. So although see 9 into 9, how much it is? 81. So if you study each combination, you get 81 possible combinations. But for illustrative purpose, they have been identified 5 combinations of styles. They are as follows. 1-1. Both are low, I told you, useless. He is not able to do anything properly. He is called as impoverished leadership. Please underline, students, please remember this terminology. Impoverished leadership is 1-1. Both are low, nor is good in people management, nor is good in production manager. Then 1-9. Low concern for production. He don't care about production, but he care about people. That is called as country club leadership. Please make a note of it. Country club. Because he take care of people. Country club. Not the production. Then 9-1. Take care of production, but least bother about people. Task leadership. So first one impoverished. 1-1. Country club. Concern for people is high. Production is low. Concern for production is high. Task leadership. Then, middle of the low leadership, 5-5 is called as middle of the low leadership, is average. The moderate concern for production, moderate concern for people. The best is 9-9, which is called as team leadership. 9-9, high concern for production and high concern for people. That is what we call it as managerial grid given by Black and Mountain. Very important grid. And these are the 5 styles of leadership given by Black and Mountain in their managerial grid. So this is how you have to draw the managerial grid. Hope you are able to understand that. Yes. Let us move on to the 4th theory of leadership, behavioral theory of leadership. The 4th one, the last one, given by Likert. Yes. Likert management system is the last theory under the behavioral category. As I told you, I am teaching you the various theories of leadership. The first one was state theory, we finished it. The second one is behavioral theory. Under that 4 we have, correct, OEO and Michigan we have done in the last class. And today we discuss about the grid. And now I am teaching you the last behavioral theory, that is Likert management system. So Likert, as the name says, Likert, is given by Rensis Likert. Rensis Likert is a professor from Michigan University, USA, and his associates made extensive research on management and leadership patterns in large number of organizations. More than 1,000 organizations they studied, Rensis Likert and his associate, and just to understand what kind of leader are successful, what style they follow, what exactly they do, to find out that. So, and he broadly classified all those leadership patterns in 4 models of management. So it is called as Likert management system. Likert is the management system. How many management systems are there? 4. system 1, system 2, system 3, system 4. So Likert evolved the four models of management as a system of management. His systems are, so please make a note of it, Likert evolved four models of management system as system of management. His systems are exploitative, authoritative, exploitative dash authoritative. So he tried to exploit the people by using his command, his power. He exploit people, he abuse them and make them do the job. That is what is system one. System two is benevolent. He will not abuse, he will not shout, he will not punish. He show love and affection, but make them do what he wants them to do. So authoritative. Authoritative is making them do what I want them to do. So exploiting method is abusive method. I'm shouting them and I'm warning them. I'm blackmailing them and making them do. Benevolent is with love, I'll make them do what I want. System 3 is consultative. Wait, I'll ask them, say I'm planning to do like this. What is your opinion on it? Do you like it or you don't like it? I'm going to ask and do. That is called as consultative. Then system 4 is, see, but consultative what happens is I'll ask them. But what they tell I will not do. I'll do what I want to do. So I'm involving them for the sake of involving and doing what I want to do. If you come across that leader, those who listen to everyone, correct, and does what he wants to do, you can call him as consultative leader. System 4 is a true democratic leader. He's participative dash democratic slash democratic. He's a combination of participative. He allow people to talk, he listen to them, and he also adopt. He will not do what he wants to do. In participation, the course of action will be selected and they will do that only. That is called democratic leader. Likert found that most individual managers and organizations fit into one or other of this system in terms of certain operating characteristics. So he says that they studied more than 1000 organizations and they found that every organization will fall under these four systems only. Nothing is there other than these four systems. Everywhere only these four systems are being followed. In some places exploitative authoritative, some places benevolent and authoritative, some place consultative, some place participative democratic. It depends upon the work they are doing it. Let it be goal setting or decision making, motivation, leadership, communication, control. So his system in terms of certain operating characteristics, and these are the characteristics given by them. So Likert system of management may be described like this. I've already explained you what it is. Just have a look. System one, management. Managers and organization system are highly autocratic. They believe in determining goals and means of achieving them. Communication is highly formal. Then management two is a master-servant relationship exists between the manager and employee. Sometimes manager adopt paternalistic attitude. I told you with love, he'll make you do what he wants you to do. He'll not listen to you. So what others? So very harsh attitude towards subordinate. Centralization is there, one-way communication, and organization environment is very stressful here. So system three, show some interest in employee and their contribution. They are being consulted, but he'll do what he wants to do. Because there's an open communication between superior and subordinate. No such control, trust and confidence between each other, reward form motivation. Correct? So allow to me that lower level of management. So that is what they do here. He listen, but he do what he wants to do. So system 4 is management. So management, what happens here is, ideal system for management, the relationship between manager and subordinate, so very cordial, very loving relationship, frank relationship. They jointly take decisions here. They involved in decision making process, goal setting process. Superiors are very supportive in nature. So these are the four systems given by Dentsis Likert, which we call it as Likert management systems. So the contribution of this, the findings of this theory is, system one oriented organization scored very poorly, while the performance of system four oriented organizations was very much creditable. So when they conducted this study, they found that people who are following system one oriented organizations were very poor. Under Hitler, who wanted to work? No one will be happy. But system four was very much good. Then he concluded that participative leadership is only valid approach to make optimum utilization of resources. When you want people to give their best, when you want people to perform to their best ability, then you have to follow, you have to be a participative leader. So that is what this theory talks about it. So for systems 2 and 3, he suggested extensive and intensive leadership training at all levels of management to move them into system 4. So worst is system 1, best is system 4. 2 and 3 need to be trained because they are partly okay, and make them to come to system 4 where they can become a successful leader. So that is what we have under the Likert system theory, Likert management system. So this ends your topic, the behavioral theories of leadership. 4 theories I taught you in 2 videos, the previous video, OYO studies and Michigan studies, and today's video, managerial grid and Likert management system. All 4 behavioral theories in detail we have discussed, students. Hope you like my video and you understood this topic. Any doubt, please write it in the comment box. Or if you like it, please like my video and share my videos to others so that their knowledge horizon will expand in terms of management. And please subscribe to my channel. So please subscribe to my channel. With that request, let me end today's class. We'll continue with next theories of leadership, that is contingency theory of leadership, in my next video. Okay, till then, take care.